Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and there's a couple things that I forgot to do. Okay, one thing is I was going to show off the Painting Guardian Curve Sword, because I sort of mentioned it. That's the Painting Guardian Curve Sword, and that's the weapon art, which is the spinning I was talking about. Okay, that's first part. The second thing is I think I figured out where I'm supposed to go in order to get to where I wanted to go with the... Here we are. With the Cathedral of the Deep on the other side of the rooftops. I think I figured it out. So it's up this tower, and then you go along, and then you get to this enemy right here. Who, I mean, at this point, the enemies are gonna be relatively trivial. And I went up this tower before, and I mean, I found the Deep Ring up here. But I missed something because I got confused. So see, what I missed is that this platform here and these rafters are not the same rafters and platform as they are below. Okay, good, I didn't roll. Whew. I was expecting a Dark Souls 2 style jump where I'd roll and then die. Ow. Okay. Ow. Okay. I have you. And another one other number over there. Over here. Yeah, there we go. That was a poorly thought out move there, little thrall. Verily poorly thought out move indeed. Oh, hey, there's some stuff down here. Including a thrall that's gonna die horribly. And one's gonna try to kill me, apparently. Let's get off these rafters first so I can get rid of this guy here. There we go. So what's over here? Or is this an observation deck? Okay, I don't know. I'm guessing that was just for a trap, potentially. Stuff would come to kill me. And it didn't, so that works, I guess. So I'm gonna go along here, and then there was a path that clearly led inside, which is what I was looking for the whole time. At least one path that led inside. Okay, we're apparently finding loads of things. Oh, can I not hit you from this? Okay, well I can hit you from another angle. Just stay put. I'll hit you just fine. Can I be hit from down there? I don't know, I think those crossbows can hit me. And what the? Oh. Apparently I was worried for nothing. Okay, never mind. Let's continue. That was weird. All right, let us continue along here. Because there are things, some of which existing only in my paranoid imagination. Seriously, that's apparently it. Okay, cool. If I don't have to deal with more enemies, that's all right. Nothing climbing over the edge. Another arbalest. Ah, there's my enemy. These are tricky rafters to fight on. Be wary of up. I was wary of up. Oh, was it? It must have been on the roof of that building. Okay. That's no secret, but I already know kind of where I'm supposed to go, so this all works out. Apparently mourning something. Ah, Pale Tongue got hit by Dark Wraith, I think? That's the Pale Tongue one, right? It's Dark Wraith? Yeah, okay. Well, not Dark Wraith, but any kind of invader. Now let's go inside. This is, I'm kind of glad I'm finally finding probably the thing I was looking for before. Probably, hopefully, maybe. I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna have to lead a bit. Ooh, headshot. Oh, gotta be kidding me. Why did I do that? Because I do not want to fight something in melee up here if I don't have to. Apparently I have to. Wow, that was not what I intended to do. Point blank crossbow, worked out. I did try range battle, it worked out very well, thank you. Admittedly, I did it beforehand, but yes. Ranged battle is of great use. And that's the other thing outside, so we're continuing along here. And another one of these knights. Oh, and that knight's also trying ranged battle. Not hitting the... Okay, there's the headshot. Can you not aim? Apparently not in a way that accounts for gravity. Must be the first thing that goes when you go hollow is losing your understanding of projectile ballistics. Ooh, one more shot and that should do it. And it was a headshot too. Six headshots in a row. Maybe I should go play Counter-Strike. Apparently I get all the headshots. Alright, so that's more probably the ranged battle stuff, I'm guessing. Below. Oh! Okay, so that's where you'd have to drop onto if you want to get to the other side, where... Yeah, so that's where Patches was down... I thought I'd jump for a second. Down there is where... That's where Patches was. And that's the... This is the thing that got lowered and that I want to raise by going along this way. So, we are making progress. I am curious, though, what's at the other end, though, because I saw another one of the thralls and I saw another bit of thing. I realize not the most descriptive way of putting it, but yes, another thrall. Trading range blows. I can live with that. Okay, as long as I get into melee range with those, it's fine. And then this knight here will not be a problem because I can just deal with him. Ow. At least I thought I could. Why can't I get behind you to backstab you? I want to backstab you. Let me put my sword in your spine. Man, you're annoying. I have a need to put swords in spines. Why is that so hard to understand? Whatever, I'll just kill you outright. You clearly did not want to redeem your free backstab. Everyone gets one. I still owe you yours. What is a blessed gem? A gem of infused titanite, commonly known as a charm kept by saints. Used in infusion to create blessed weapons. Special blessed weapons gradually restore HP and heavily damage reanimated foes. You mean, like, skeletons, I guess? Or zombies? Because I'm thinking, we're talking about a world full of undead. Who is not reanimated here? I guess it would make sense for Undead Hollows. There are, I guess, like, golems and such? Or giants? Or... Some bosses, I guess, would count as not being reanimated. I'm just thinking that's the only thing that comes to mind. Ow. Okay. I would have wanted to do that before I drop down, but this'll work out. So yeah, I actually have the Aldrich Ruby on. I regain health by backstabbing, and I actually regain a fair amount of health by backstabbing too, so it's not really a bad idea to backstab stuff. Oh. I also have the Ring of the Evil Eye on, so every single kill gives me health. Which is rather helpful. And now we got the shortcut again. Now we got the bridge again. Perfect. I finally succeeded in this task of getting through to this area. I wonder what else is over here. Why would I try ranged battle? Huh. Deep protection gives me extra attack power too, so that's kind of why. I don't think it applies to crossbows though, but I could be wrong. Also, I totally see what they mean by tri-range battle at this point. Everything's damaged. And I've regained all my health! Hooray! So, what's the point of this bit then? Oh! Hey, a red sand soapstone! That's how you get it! I was kind of wondering, because I felt like I should have gotten that a long time ago. Online play item. Create a hostile invasion red sign. Hostile red invasion sign. Be summoned to another world as a dark spirit and defeat the host of embers to gain the strength of fire. Not all dark spirits are unsport. Not all dark spirits are unsporting, or they wouldn't make use of this soapstone. And now, what's this? Bonfire! Neat. Okay, not that I don't already have a shortcut up here that I can take trivially, but hey, why not have a bonfire? Am I embered up? Yes, I am embered up. I have 885 health. That means I've embered up. Huh. More stuff. Hazel pick. Choice weapon of Yellowfinger Hazel, a finger of Rosaria, and Xanthus Scholar. This is both weapon and a sorcery staff. The gold specks are remnants of lost sorceries. Skill is steady chant, which boosts the strength of the sorceries for a short period. And the other one was the Xanthus crown. The yellow hat. Crown supposedly made an imitation of a divine creature of Ulysseal, land of ancient golden sorceries. Xanthus clothing is the mark of a researcher of lost sorceries, and the oversized crown is emblematic of their work. Such a curious pursuit is surely nothing to be ashamed of. Although, yeah, everyone remembers Xanthus King Jeremiah, right? Oh, there's Rosaria! Okay, now I can get into the dark... Or the... I guess this is the Dark Wraith. No. Oh! Okay, so I can... Nice! Neat! Okay, so this is how you do... Because I was wondering, I had heard that there was a way of doing... Like, soul... Well... What's it called? Respecking. That's it. I heard that was a way to do respec in Dark Souls 3. I didn't know what it was. In Dark Souls 2, you got an item called a Soul Vessel, and then you went back to the Fire Keepers at the very, 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 very start of the game, and you talked to one of them, and they'd reallocate your stats. Apparently, in this case, you can do it through Pale Tongues, and you can also remake your character to make them look better. Now, granted, I spent, like, 12 tries making this character look like they did. Thankfully, there's a favorite system that allowed me to save between tries, so I could just tweak existing ones that I knew, oh yeah, I like this, but the chin's a bit too big, or I like this, but the cheekbones are a little too wide, or a little too narrow, and finally get the character the way I want. I could finally look the way I want it to look. But that's cool. So if I ever want to reallocate stats, which at this point I don't, I think I'm pretty proud, or pretty glad of the stats I have now. Although I suppose I could use it to double check what attunement level I could get, or other potentials like that. like when I get four attunement slots or when I get different elements of things. Also, I wanted to check. No, it doesn't make a difference. I mean, it makes a difference if I two-hand because it'll change the weapon strength, but I don't know if it's because it's causing strength to increase. I don't think so, honestly, because if my... It's 305. Every time I raise strength by a level, it goes up by three. Like two or three. 305 to 335, so it went up by 30, which means effectively it gained 10 levels of strength, I guess? Actually, no, if it goes up by two or three each time, that actually would make sense. It could be that. The only way to really test it would be to raise strength to 40 and then see if two-handing increases the weapon attack power at all. And if it does, then that means that strength of 40 is actually useful. If not, then that means that strength of 27 is the highest you really should go. Oh yeah, and also story time. I'll teleport out of here once I'm done here, because I don't think there's anything else in the cathedral. Rosaria's Fingers. Sacred seal of Archdeacon Klimt, who served Rosaria, Mother of Rebirth. Equipped to pledge oneself to the Rosaria's Fingers Covenant. Rosaria's Fingers collect tongues in her name. Some do it to be reborn, others do it to help comfort their voiceless goddess. Huh. Now I'm thinking about all the times my tongue has presumably been cut out. Because, you know, dying to invaders. How many tongues do I have? I guess I get a new one every single time I teleport, or every single time I die. Or just every time I hit a bonfire, my tongue regrows, if it needed to. Alright, back up to Lothric Castle. So we knew what happened going down the left way. At least partially. Whoa, okay. That was weird. So what happens going this way? What about to the right? What happens this way? Absolutely nothing. Okay, and the staircases don't even connect. Purely decorative. Okay. Well, that sucks. And what's up front? Looks like one of those enemies that screeches. And a knight. Not an enemy that screeches, but it is a red-eye knight. Yeah! Backstab! Get my health back. Now is not a good time to get invaded by a dark spirit, would you? Okay, now is an okay time. Large Titanite shards! Not that I need them anymore, and what's up here? Soul of a Crestfallen Knight. Time for weapon. Oh, is this another quest? Is this part of a quest? I need to drop off a weapon here for someone later on? Or... what? Okay, that's an elevator for further up. It's another red-eye knight. And that's an assassin type thing. Where is my invader? Like, they're clearly in this area somewhere. But I don't know where. I also don't know if that elevator goes up or down. There they are! Okay, you're not gonna be sporting. Got it. Oh, crap. Oh, okay, so they get buffed, and that is a problem. I got killed by a shield? Why did that guy invade me? He didn't even fight me, what the heck? I guess they were waiting for me to screw up and go next to that Lothric Knight. The Red Eye Lothric Knight. Okay, so we know what's up here. I want to get rid of the buffer first before that knight gets buffed. Darn it, these guys are hard to backstab. I really wanted to backstab. I'm trying to get that Aldrich Ruby to pay off. I'm trying to get backstabs, but it's just, I can never seem to get the backstabs. I don't know what it is. Where's the backstab point? I have no idea. Thought I knew, and just keep trying to get close, and then I keep getting smacked by a shield. Kind of feel like I'm going the wrong way, almost. Like I should be going down to the lower area, dealing with the slightly easier enemies down there, and then going up here. But I don't know. I mean, at this point, the character's level 90 and has fairly well upgraded equipment. I don't think that's really a thing anymore. Well, I'll just slash you dead then. Hit you enough times, it doesn't matter what I do. Maybe I should get more endurance at some point. Yeah, that spelt my doom last time. Oh, a spear-wielding one? Oh, wait, you're not a red-eye, though. Oh, this game, why can't you let me kick? I realized that kicking is actually a bit more flexible than I mentioned in my mechanics analysis video. But it's still not that flexible. Oh wait, that was a perfect backstab position. Ah, come on! Should've gone for that backstab. How did that guy even spot me? Did it really move down that far? I don't know how I'm gonna deal with these things. Like, I cannot kick reliably, that's so annoying. Like, I'm even double tapping it so that I make sure I'm facing the direction, and it still screws up. I don't know what I'm doing. Seriously? Ugh! One shot? How much health do I need? I must be undervigored. I just don't know how to. I don't like vigor. Like, I don't like to get health. That's the thing. It feels like a waste of a stat. But I feel like I have to. Or I have to ember up, I guess. Just then I'll get invaded again, and then I'll cut that progress short again. Must you be so aggressive? Oh great, I got buffed. Exactly what I was trying to avoid. Come on, let me hit them. What are you doing? Why are you protecting your teammate? What is wrong? Well, I guess that's actually a good strategy, but why are you being smart? Be stupid. Be stupid for my sake. Your intelligence is annoying me. That and my inability to kick properly. For some reason, this game just doesn't let me. Ah. Wasting so many Estus flasks. Finally, the buff's gone. Alright. Would that kicks were reliable in this game. I mean, I guess I can always do this, but I keep forgetting about that. Why can't I backstab you? Let me backstab you! Finally, I get a backstab! Sheesh! I don't want it so hard for me, just let me backstab it. Okay, that's two down. Just one more. I'll probably give myself the extra defense and attack, because that's always helpful. Seriously, that low on stamina? But I had enough stamina. Guess I do until I find an enemy that requires that I roll 24 times before I'm able to get an attack in. So used to enemies that I can just roll once and then slash them 6 times. Okay, so I do need more stamina. I thought if I have dexterity, that's fine. I'll just get more attack power and won't need stamina. Apparently I was wrong. Thought you could fool me by playing dead. Or at least playing sitting down passively and therefore not being a concern. I've got my eyes out. Oh, they're good, there's a bonfire. Thinking I really want a bonfire or something so I don't have to go through that again. What's this? How many of these swords are there? They look nice. But, I don't know, but it's like, that's the second one I've seen. Did this mass produce these? I half expect they do. Hey, I think we're back at the cathedral, actually. And around where the staircases look to be relatively vestigial. Oh, I see. That's the right side. And the left side I've already been through? I guess that was a whole loop. Or the straight side, I mean, the forward way. Going forward was done. Whole loop, not much else. What's this message here? Not sure who the nimble one is. Perhaps a New Game Plus thing. Although, as far as I can tell from assisting people who are in New Game Plus, not a whole lot changes in New Game Plus. You might get different drops like you did in Dark Souls 2, but not much else. Oh, right, there's another path. What am I thinking? And go right here. Or forward, rather. That is a proper chest. Interesting. What is this? The Robe of Prayer. Prince Lothric's robe. The prince, destined to be a Lord of Cinder, was cherished by the royal family despite being born into illness, a frail and shriveled child. Wait a sec, have I not? I thought I got these before. Well, okay, whatever. Try fire, huh? Very well. that might mean pyromancy. I don't know. Clearly it's not what I think it is. Is there something up the chimney? Nope, that's actually not a chimney. That's completely blocked in. So if you were to burn stuff in there, I guess you'd have this window. But you wouldn't have a chimney, that's for sure. And another titanite jump, nice. Okay, high wall soldiers. Considerably stronger versions of high wall soldiers. Ah, seriously? Well, you guys I can backstab relatively trivially. Get the health back that way. Man, just like old... What the heck? That was a failed backstab. I was gonna say just like old times, but then you went over from the backstab. What the heck? Ah, you had to pull it away just in time, didn't you? I'm really desperate for those backstabs. Wow, Volotaria reference, alright. We're back to that. We're back to the Demon Souls references with enemies hanging out behind these arrow walls, or these walls designed to block arrows. Oh, crap. I've never actually fought one of these things fair. And apparently I'm gonna die, because the stupid... Why did that stupid pillar get in my way? Or anything? I keep expecting enemies to be... passed through. Like, I keep expecting to roll through enemies. It's probably a fighting game thing. I expect that from games like King of Fighters, where your roll obviously goes through, because what else could it possibly do? I mean, you're talking about a game where you... basically don't have any real way of getting past your opponent except jumping over them, or in this case rolling through them, because it's 2D. Huh. Of course, I need my souls back. Would quite like them back. Thank you very much. Oh. Off you go. Into the abyss. Ah. Talk about efficiency. Alright, where are my souls? Over there. Oh, that's where that enemy is. So I can actually get the drop on them again, like I did last time. Or just avoid them entirely. Oh, hey. Illusory wall. Neat. Oh, winged stuff. Okay, so I was just fighting. And Sacred Bloom Shield, so all the Winged Knight armor. No, I don't want to sort. That's the wrong button. Winged Knight armor. Armor of the Winged Knights, named for their appearances, who swore themselves to the angels. Worship of the divine messengers was viewed as heresy in Lothric and unrecognized by any of the three pillars of rule. This is believed to be why Gertrude, the Heavenly Daughter, was imprisoned in the lofty cell of the Grand Archives. Ooh, got something to look for. I'm guessing I have to unimprison her at some point. Yeah, okay, not much else there. And I'm guessing the shield has got something on it. Nope. A treasured antique of the Way of White, known to some as the Sorcerer's Bane. The large blossom design that graces the shield is said to be a sacred flame, and the shield is blessed with high magic protection. And it deflects spells, apparently. No. Oh. Okay. Cool. So... I guess that gives me a way out of fighting the Winged Knight. I mean, I kind of want to just get the drop on the thing. Or, you know, arrow in the head. That works too. Bolt to the head. What? That throws his weapon? Well, it's a bad time to throw your weapon away, that's for sure. Boy, you ever regret that now. No, oh, I guess I should probably heal. That's just embarrassing. You had something on you? Oh, another chunk, nice. Another upgrade. Ow, whoa, what the? Oh no. Stupid. What's she, oh, is there? I think their bolt has Aloy's talisman effect on it as well. Wow, what the hell? At least I don't have to deal with the Winged Knight, but what the hell? Okay, I'll try going through that one more time. And I guess I pretty much need to Ember up, for crying out loud. That's a lot tougher than I expected. Hey. Give me some health. Give me some more health. Yeah. Aldrich's Ruby actually provides a lot of extra health, so I'm quite glad of that. And then the Ring of the Evil Eye for just in case I don't manage to get Aldrich's Ruby to work. I at least have something. But if I do get it to work, then I get a lot of damage, and that's awesome. Ah! Okay, now to grab my... There's my souls. Ow. Ah, would you not hit me? For 2 seconds. That was a critical attack chance? Where are you? How did you hit me? Oh, I see. It's different things throwing the Lloyd's talismans. Oy. There we go, got a backstab. Good. Needed that. Oh, I thought I'd get another one. So many large shards. Well, I guess if I needed large shards before, I certainly don't now. What the heck are throwing the Lloyd's talismans? Or undead hunter charm, that's what it's. You! Yeah, better be careful. Watch my step here. Certainly no additional threat, but I don't like you. Okay, what's over here before... I mean, I might as well pick up the last item before I move along. And hey, that's enough for the crossbow. Actually, it's 4 titanite chunks in total, so I'm going to be upgrading the crossbow between episodes. Sounds like a good plan to me. What in the world are those? Those do not look friendly. Okay, good. Can never be too sure. Oh, and some of the bonfire. Seems like a good place as any to end the episode then, because bonfire! And more embers and no illusory walls. Alright, cool. So we are probably done this episode. I think we're done this episode. very good place to end it. Right, so thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that, and see you next time.